Hey everybody, so this is my Guillow's Fairchild 24 remote control conversion. And in this video, I'm going to show you how I made this airplane and some tips and tricks I think that you can use when you convert your Guillow's RC kits as well. As you can see, I tried to copy the color scheme that came on the box. I think it looked cool. I'm going to go over a few of the changes that I made to make it remote control. And for powered electric flight. So as you can see, here's the finished airplane. It came out really nice. There's a couple changes I had to make that are pretty significant. See the battery carbon on the bottom? I might put a cover on that in the future. We'll start from the beginning. The nose and work to the back. So, for electronics in here, we've got this eFlight VL180 motor and a 5x3 prop that kind of was just suggested to go with it. So, I had to bring the firewall forward from what it suggested on the plans a little bit, and I used this 8th inch plywood. Don't want to knock over my camera. It was hard to cut, but it's really, really strong, so the screws will be able to hold into that, and even with the slightly unbalanced prop, should never rip out. So the motor, it goes back to the this receiver brick I got. It's an eFlight brand as well. It's ESC receiver and two linear servos. So I can show you that up close in a minute here. And all that is run on 2S 300 milliamp hour battery, which I can grab one right here to show you. They're very, very small. Not that big. This one comes with a bunch of different connectors. Well, one's the balancing plug. This JST and the PH2.0, I think it's called. I went with this one. It's very, very light. So I chose to solder that into the bottom here. And I'll show you up close how I pulled the batteries in. So inside of the plane, I actually have the battery box and a rubber band. So the battery slides in and it has a bit of friction so it can hold. I've got fat fingers right in the way. It'll hold itself, but if you're gonna be doing any maneuvers with any sort of G's or any sort of bumps when you take off and land, I have this rubber band. Very advanced. Let's see that well. It goes over the battery to prevent it from escaping. One thing that's interesting about this kit that you really have to make sure you follow the rules, the instructions on, is the articulated landing gear. So this is standard Guillow's landing gear wire, but it also has this strange hook design, which makes it so this spar is not actually connected to your wing, because when you touch down in tall grass or anything really, your landing gear is going to get pushed back and it needs to be able to wobble. So that's your suspension right there. Another change I made on the airplane is that I ditched the solid wooden static display wheels that it came with, and I 3D printed some really light wheels that are like half a gram each. So that way adding landing gear doesn't affect the CG really at all. It doesn't add too much weight to the plane. Of course, with your Guillow's kits, they don't have control surfaces, so what I have to do here is design a hinge into the back. I chose to not use solid balsa wood because I like the way the spars look and they're very light. Maybe if you put it from the light here, you can see. I kept the design of the control surfaces and I just added this 16th by quarter inch strip down the line that was suggested in the plans, and I made some hinges between there. And I can show you what I used the hinge material. I actually used these page markers from like Office Sewer. They were the perfect material to cut up into really thin, light, little flexible hinges, slot your balsa wood and slide it in, and drop some ultra thin CA glue in there to bond them. And then another change I had to make, or just the problem I had to solve, was how to get my servo action from up here to back there. So for all the control arms and control horns, what I did here is I have I have 1 millimeter carbon fiber to cover most of the distance inside the airplane. Heat shrinked onto that is this 0.3 millimeter spring steel wire. And you've got to put this big loop in here, so that way if your center settings are a little bit off, either way you can use some pliers and gently adjust. Also, I want to point out that I used some, let's focus, some see-through acrylic plastic down here. Actually, it's not acrylic, take that back. Some see-through plastic of some sort for my control horn, so they're actually kind of hard to see. It just gives the airplane a nice look when it's displayed, or even when it's flying, you don't see any white little plastic tabs or anything. So I covered the whole thing up in just craft store tissue paper. It's nothing special, so it's a bit fragile, but it's really, really light. The whole plane has a flying weight of about 3 ounces. I need to reweigh it now that I added the landing gear on. But I'm a huge fan of this model. It's got a really sleek look to it. Love being able to see the balsa under the tissue. Flies great. I'm really excited to show you guys how it flies. It's extremely cold out, so I can't really fly it too often right now, but I'll get some footage and give that a whirl. So what I'm gonna do now is just demonstrate plugging the airplane, turning on everything, and show you what kind of functionality this thing has. So, got my controller on. Sometimes it just messes up the first time. Okay, so right now it's armed and ready to fly. I obviously should be careful with this propeller, but it's really not gonna slice me up too bad. So, you can see we've got up and down elevator authority. Left and right on the rudder, it actually goes all the way up to here. From my experience so far, I'd probably say that this is too much throw. I might want to put some expo on it, but I really like being able to push it to that limit if I really need to turn the plane around fast, because it's three channel, no ailerons. So if I get in a spicy situation, I really want to be able to have some control. And of course, this thing has plenty of power. I mean, 2S on a plane this light is definitely gonna get the job done. And actually, this radio came with that AS3X technology, I think it's called, so. You can see how it corrects. I originally wanted to take that out because I kind of learned to fly without it and I was a bit skeptical, but I gotta say, it really makes this little tiny plane handle like something maybe four times its weight when it comes to wind. So it's a good feature, leave it on, it's great. One problem I had with this receiver that was easy to solve actually, but it took some research, is reversing the servo directions. There's actually an advanced programming manual, and it goes through steps about how to turn on the receiver while holding the sticks at very specific positions, and you can program the receiver by doing that. So maybe I'll link that manual in the description. Here's just a bit of a run up to show you how it rolls on this 3D printed landing gear.
It flew!